Hey everyone, welcome to another edition of Ask a Zookeeper, where we have two zookeepers present to answer your questions. If you have any questions about any kind of animal, birds, underwater animals, whatever, feel free to ask those in the comments below. And we will open with a question from one of our viewers.
So one of our viewers was wondering about bird eyes. How do they work? How are they able to zoom in on their prey?
Okay, I did some research to answer this question. Birds have really long, flexible necks. They have between 7 and 22 cervical vertebrae in their neck. So like a heron with the long, bendy, flexible neck, that's why it's able to bend and flex that much. One of the theories as to why they have so many vertebrae in their neck is that it keeps their head still. So if you've ever held a parrot, which I know you have, and you kind of like move your hand around and the bird is focusing on something, the bird's head will stay perfectly still even as you move your hand around. And that's because they have so many, that's the theory as to why they have so many neck vertebrae, is so that they can have lots of flexibility to keep their head in place. Keeping their head in place has a couple of advantages. One of them is that they can see prey. They can see prey or predators by keeping their head still as they move their bodies. They have that steady field of vision that they can either look out the side if they're a prey animal, or they can look out the front if they're a predator animal and see with a steady field of vision. The other advantage for keeping their head still is so that when they're landing, their feet and their bodies are impacting the ground pretty hard, because even from a slow flight, it's a significant impact, and that way they don't get brain damage and die whenever they land.
That makes a lot of sense. That's really cool.
There was actually a group of filmmakers that put a small camera on the head of a chicken, put the chicken in a boat, and they were going around in the boat, and the chicken was keeping its head still. So they were trying to see if it would be a good shock absorber for motion, and so maybe that'll be the future of film technology. Chickens. Instead of a tripod or something, we'll have just a chicken.
Yeah, that doesn't sound distracting at all.
Right, yeah. Or like the chicken starts walking away and it starts pecking around and stuff. Like, wow, that was a great scene. How does it... Oh, where's the chicken?
That sounds like a really good idea for a cartoon or something.
Sure, yeah.
Sounds hilarious.
Chicken working in the movie business is the new type of tripod.
Yeah. That could be a good idea for like a kid's movie.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. About jobs that birds can get. Yeah, there's a world where birds need jobs, and one of them is camera operator, and it's chickens only.
Okay. What other kinds of jobs would birds be good at? I bet a bird would be a really good surveyor.
What does a surveyor do?
They map out the land. They map out different
plots
and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Because if they could just fly up into the air and be like, there, 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 then they'd be good at surveying.
Yeah, they could draw maps and stuff. Mm-hmm. That'd be awesome.
Yeah, they would be good at exploring. Like, exploring Mount Everest would be pretty easy. They'd be
like, I was thinking volcanoes, but yours is a lot more realistic.
Well, exploring Mount Everest isn't a job, but anyway, any mountain range that needs studying.
Well, geological exploration is jobs. They could do that. Although, this was the premise for a kid's movie, so birds and jobs, let's pretend humans don't exist in the universe.
Okay. So birds have to have every job, even the ones they're bad at.
Yes.
Like, construction? Yeah, not good.
I don't know. Crows know how to use tools.
Yeah, crows know how to use tools. I think more buildings would be made out of spit and mud instead of wood.
They'd be really good entertainers, though, especially like cockatoos and some parrots.
Sure. Yeah.
Good at making music and...
Yeah, singing. They're the cockatoos that make rhythm also. They're the ones that hit the branches.
Yep. Yeah, and then you could have other species of birds make different types of music. Mm-hmm. Like canaries would make their own style and then... Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So
the cockatoos would be like the rock metalists of the world, the bird world.
Yeah, yeah.
I would definitely go see this movie. You know what else cockatoos would be good at?
What?
Party planning.
You know what would be awesome? And then everyone's crest in the meeting goes...
I'm picturing that scene. It's awesome.
So please make that movie. Amanda will watch it. To get back to the actual question, though, the way that bird eyes work is that, so here's some various interesting facts about bird eyes. A lot of birds have two fovea, or the central part of their eye that provides a greater sense of vision. So like birds of prey, they have one in the center of their eye and one off to the side. Or there are some birds that actually have bifocal lenses, one that focuses on the horizon so they can keep an eye out for predators, and one that keeps an eye downwards looking for prey as they're flying above. And one of the big questions that I've always had about birds, this is going to take a little bit of explaining before I can even explain why it's cool.
Okay.
We talked about in the bird sleep video that birds can close one of their eyes and sleep the opposite half of their brain. And that is because they don't have a corpus callosum linking the two halves of their brain. So if one side goes of their brain goes to sleep, which is really cool, the other one can stay awake and keep an eye out for predators. But the way that depth perception works is the two halves of the brain are comparing visual images with each other, and depth perception comes from the comparing the two images. So my question was always, in the absence of a connection between the two halves of the brain, each of which controls one eye, how does the bird have any depth perception at all? And that is the question that I finally found the answer to.
Oh, perfect.
So the answer is, have you ever seen a lorikeet, and it's getting ready to take off, and it bobs its head up and down really quickly? What it is doing is it's basically making two eyeballs worth of visual data. So the top and the bottom of its head bob, it compares the images between the top and the bottom, and mm-hmm. that is, gives it enough binocular vision that it can then judge distance.
Okay.
So it does all the work that we do with two eyes, it does all the work with one eye.
But in this scenario, they would have both eyes open,
they
right?
have both eyes open, but in a lorikeet's case especially, the eyes are facing in totally different directions.
Right, okay.
There's a little bit of overlap right in the front, but they're...
Not enough to get a proper amount of, okay, how far away is that thing I want to land on?
Right.
Okay.
And so even during flight, they can bob their head side to side or up and down, and that gives them enough visual data that they can avoid crashing into things. And that's how birds don't die every time they fly.
That's great. Man, birds are just the coolest.
I know. It's something that makes so much sense. Like, oh gosh, birds don't die every time they fly. But it, like...
When you learn the mechanics behind how how that happens or doesn't happen, it's pretty cool.
Yeah. And I'm sure the birds are like, well, how do you do it?
Yeah. I don't know if they have the mental capability to wonder that, but...
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. But if they did, they would be like... Well, how do your brains work? Why you have to sleep both halves of your brain every time you sleep? You can't just sleep half?
Yeah. I wonder what else birds would wonder about us if they had that capability.
Yeah. I feel bet they'd want to know about hands.
Yeah. No, I was just going to say, feel free to leave some comments if there's something you think
Please
birds would
know.
Wonder about.
If you were a bird, what would you want to know about humans?
Mm-hmm. All right. I have another question kind of related to this. So you were mentioning how predator and prey birds have their eyes on different parts. Are there any birds that would be considered both?
Both a predator and a prey
animal? Yeah.
After much deliberation and thought, I cannot think of a single bird that eats birds and is also eaten by birds. So okay. If you know a bird that is eaten by birds but also eats birds, let us know. Because you probably have thought of it already, and you're probably screaming, like, ah! So just write that in the comments, and then you'll look really smart.
I hope you've liked our video.
If you want to learn more about animals, feel free to watch these other videos, or you can subscribe to know when a new Ask Two Zookeepers Zookeepers comes out. Thanks for stopping by this week to learn what makes life awesome.
Zookeepers? I'm thinking that's another job.
I'm just gonna leave that.
Love it.
Oh my god, Zookeepers.